Hello my friends, my name is Amner Hunter from amnerhunter.com, and in today's video I'm gonna be checking out 10 of the best VST plugins to get a crushing rock and metal bass tone using free VST plugins and also paid VST plugins. In this video I'm gonna be sharing some additional information about these plugins. Also, I wanna show you how I set up the session in my DAW to get quickly a good bass tone, and also how I mix this sound with guitars and bass. I am gonna dial each one of the plugins in solo, and also I am gonna compare them in a full mix with drums and guitars. All of the applicable links are going to be down below in the description and first comment, and don't forget to check out the timestamps as well that I leave you down below. Thank you very much for being here and welcome my friends. Before we dive into the content, I would like to invite you to my website amnerhunter.com, where I have some free stuff available at your disposal. I have some free PDF guides and ebooks for music producers and guitar players. Also, I have some tools such as a huge collection of guitar impulses, my Cubase mixing template, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out my blog, which I'm updating weekly with tons of free content. So now let's get to the video. So the first six VST plugins are free. The first one, it's the SHB1 from Ignite Amps. This is an emulation of a real SHB1 Extreme Bass head. It's a plugin available for Mac and Windows, and you have the download buttons right here. It doesn't work only as a preamp, but also it works as a power amp. The next one is from the company Lost in 70s, and this is the Bass Deluxe. It's the head, and also it has a cabinet emulations. It's available for Mac and Windows in 64 and 32 bits. The next one is the Bass Grinder Free from Audio Assault. It's available for Mac and Windows in 64 bits and 32 as well. This is not exactly an emulation. It includes two amplifiers and three cabinets. The next one in the list is the CL Bass F by Exe Consulting and Dave Clark. This one is only available for Windows in 64 bits. And if you go here to downloads, you're gonna be able to download it right away. This one is from the company TSE Audio. This is the BOD. This is an emulation of the well-known Sansamp bass pedal. You can download the plugin here. It's available for Mac and Windows in 32 and 64 bits. The next one is from the company Nalex, and this is a recent release. This is that bass amp, just like that. As you can see here, this is an emulation of the Ampeg SVT amplifier. It's available for Mac and Windows in 64 bits and 32 as well. You have the direct buttons to download it here. And we move on to the paid ones. This is the Clank from Audio Assault. You have a free trial available. It's available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. The limitation is that every 15 minutes, the plugin resets. I'm gonna try to get you a coupon code for a discount. This one, it's in $34.99. If I'm able to get this coupon code for you of this discount, you're gonna be seeing that on the video description. This one includes also cabinet simulation, includes some effects such as compression and EQ in post. The next one is from the company JST, Joy Sturgis Tones, and this is that Joel Wanasek Boss Glue Bass. It's a powerful plugin where you sculpt very easily a rock and metal bass tone. Right now it's in $59. It's available for Mac and Windows in 32 and 64 bits. The next one is from the company Aurora Dsp, and this is the Mammoth. Right now it's on sale on VST Boss. It's 57% off, so 29 euros at the moment. It's a powerful plugin that includes bass maximizer, drives, tone stack, cabinet emulation. You can shape the tone pretty easily, and you have awesome presets that I always use, to be honest. So you have some days remaining in case that you want to take advantage of this offer. And the last one in the list is from the company Neural DSP. This is the Parallax. It's a 99 euro plugin. You get access to a 14-day free trial, fully featured. This one, it's available for Mac and Windows as well. You can shape the tone with three bands, low, mids, and highs. So you have tons of control here, and you also have an equalizer to further shape the tone. So now let's go to my DAW to show you how I set up the session. For the final demo that you're gonna be hearing at the end of the video, I made this drums, guitars, and bass, and I copy basically 10 times the bass guitar, guitar riff, and drum groove. As you can see, I have the 10 tracks here of the bass. In each track, I put one plugin. That's the only thing that I'm doing on the channel. You see here the different plugins, the free ones, and then the paid ones right here. These individual tracks are being sent to this bass bus, and I have this equalizer that it's being applied to all of the bass tracks. The only EQ move that I did here is I applied a high pass filter at around 55 hertz so that it won't compete with the kick drum. I tried to separate the frequencies in this matter from the kick drum and the bass guitar. That's the only EQ move that I have here. And after the equalizer, I have this limiter where I link the threshold and the out. I am pretty much crushing with limiting the bass guitar to control the dynamics, to have it consistent throughout the track. Limiting it's a normal thing these days to be able to control bass sound, especially in a dense metal mix where you have guitars and drums. I can get up to 5, 6, 7 maybe of gain reduction to crush really the dynamics of the bass to be able to have a more consistent low end also on the song. And of course I am using the volume faders here to balance the tracks with the drums and guitars and between each one of them. This bass group or bass bus is being sent to this master channel or mix bus where I have this equalizer where I am just high passing at around 40 hertz the whole mix, right, with guitars and drums included. And I am using this compressor with a slow attack, fast release ratio of 3:1 just to control the dynamics of the full mix, to glue the whole mix all together, just getting around 2 to 3 decibels of gain reduction. And at the end of the signal chain, I have this limiter again, where I'm setting a ceiling of -1, lowering the threshold, just getting around 2 to 3 decibels of gain reduction here in the full mix, just to bring up the volume and the loudness of the song for the final demo that you're gonna be checking out at the end of the video. For further consideration, my friends, I used a low volume on the drums and bass compared to the bass tone. I wanted the bass to stand out in the mix, of course, for you to be able to capture the character of each one of the amplifiers and the bass tone that I got. So now let's check out these crushing bass tones isolated and finally in the full mix. We'll be right back.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Please let me know down below in the comments, my friends, what you think about these bass VST plugins. Do you have a favorite? Which one sounded best for you in the context of the full mix? Have you tried them before? If you have any additional suggestions, please let me know. I'll be happy to read your comments. Before we go, my friends, I would like to invite you to my website, amnerhunter.com, where I have some free additional stuff for you. I have a couple of guides and PDF ebooks for music producers and guitar players. I have some free tools as well, a huge collection of guitar impulses, my Cubase mixing template, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out my blog, which I'm updating weekly with tons of free content. Thank you very much for watching the video, and I'll see you very soon on the next one. All right, take care.